हर कदम आसान है, इसे बढ़ाइए। ब्लाइंड ग्रेजुएट्स फोरम ऑफ इंडिया के मेंटरशिप प्रोग्राम से जुड़िए। कुछ लोग उनकी मंजिल तक पहुंच रहे हैं, उनके अनुभव का लाभ उठाइए।
अगर आप स्टूडेंट हो और आप अपने करियर को लेकर कंफ्यूज्ड हो, तो इनकी गाइडेंस और डायरेक्शन आपके लिए वैल्यूबल है। कई फील्ड्स के कामयाब प्रोफेशनल से वन ऑन वन मेंटरशिप आपके लिए अवेलेबल होगी।
अधिक जानकारी के लिए कॉल कीजिए 9892145699, ईमेल कीजिए contact@bgfi.in। गेट मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑन www.bgfi.in। अब आपकी भी मंजिल होगी।
Have a proud product capsule. We have a very interesting product called BrailleMe. So let's start with the session on safety. What is safety for you? Or the general perception of people is that for a person with disability, when it comes to safety, they are dependent on others for their safety as well as of others' safety around them. Do you agree with that? Should you be responsible for your own safety or somebody else?
We should be responsible.
Somebody said we. And somebody said 50-50. So let's see what our expert says, and through the session we'll know whether it is only we or me as an individual who is responsible for my own safety, or is it everybody as a community. So we have Ravi Kishore Donthikurthi. He is a civil engineer and he's done his MOOC post graduation in industrial safety and environmental management. He's been working in health and safety area for around 6 years, and currently he's working with FedEx as senior health and safety expert specialist. And let's hear from Ravi Kishore, and let's welcome Ravi.
हर कदम आसान है, इसे बढ़ाइए। ब्लाइंड ग्रेजुएट्स फोरम ऑफ इंडिया के मेंटरशिप प्रोग्राम से जुड़िए। कुछ लोग उनकी मंजिल तक पहुंच रहे हैं, इनके अनुभव का लाभ उठाइए।
अगर आप स्टूडेंट हो और आप अपने करियर को लेकर कंफ्यूज्ड हो, तो इनकी गाइडेंस और डायरेक्शन आपके लिए वैल्यूएबल है। कई फील्ड्स के कामयाब प्रोफेशनल से वन ऑन वन मेंटरशिप आपके लिए अवेलेबल होगी।
अधिक जानकारी के लिए कॉल कीजिए 9892145699, ईमेल कीजिए contact@bgfi.in। Get more details on www.bgfi.in। अब आपकी भी मंजिल होगी।
Thank you everyone. Very good evening to you all.
Good evening.
So what I do is my Hindi is very bad. So I request you to adjust with my Hindi speaking skills. I'm sure you'll be okay with that. I'm from South India, so I can speak, but lately I've lost touch talking in it, but I'll try. Today's topic, when I spoke to Vishal, I must start the session with thanking him for giving me an opportunity aapke saath engage karne ke liye, because this session is not more on aapko kuch gyan nahi de raha hu. What I do is I tell you some stories, and these are real incidents, and yes, stories ke through I'll My attempt is to not answer every question. My attempt is to make you think and make you question certain safety aspects. Now, coming back to the question, I think when Vishal asked, is there responsibility of the safety? I think one gentleman said 50-50, I like that answer. And we know why. And as you were saying, it is our own responsibility, that is also true. Before I start, मेरे background में मेरे work profession में मैं बहुत सारे training देता रहता हूँ safety related. And first thing when I start doing this session, everybody says safety is a बहुत boring topic. You know, and उससे भी worst answer is safety is very dry subject. I don't know what I mean by dry. Dry is better, like dry manchuria, dry starters and everything. And I like it that way. See, I try to make as much interactive as this session can go. So, मैं आपसे कुछ सवाल भी पूछूंगा. I request you to answer. Okay? So, without much ado, let me start with a story number one. Okay? Now, this happened in Bangalore. Everybody with me? Yeah? This happened in Bangalore. Yeah, this was very widely covered in media and paper, print and all. This story is about a fire accident on one of the high-rise buildings in Mumbai, and it's in Bangalore. People who are aware and acquainted with the area, it happened in Koramangala place. Okay. So it's a tragic incident. What happened is the building caught fire, and when the building caught fire, people panicked. They called for fire, ambulance, and police and all those supporting team members. While it was happening, most of them could escape, except for one gentleman. He was in fact actually tweeting his live status, saying I'm still stuck in one of the corners. Main yahan mere pure floor pe smoke aa gaya hai. I'm not able to see anything. Things like that. So media was following that also closely. Unfortunately, the fire tender people couldn't save him. And there is a reason to it also. So most of them escaped out of the situation. But this gentleman couldn't. And he was stuck at one of the corners in the building, and he succumbed to the breathing and the smoke injuries that he had. Now hold on to this story, I'll tell you one more. Similar incident happened in Delhi, and this was in a very popular hotel. I'm sure you guys would have heard. The hotel also got fire. While most of the people got injured, there was one family which escaped without any injuries, without any trouble from that situation. Now that family was a UK family, British family, and they were the So what do you think? अभी मैंने ये दो केसेस मैंने आपको बताया. Like what could have gone wrong? Case one, एक बिल्डिंग में when everybody could go out, what could have gone wrong so that one gentleman couldn't go out and there was a fire incident? आपके हिसाब से क्या लगता है? Now what क्या गलती उसने किया होगा क्या गलती? Yes, please.
ये हुआ कि उनको जो बचने का रास्ता सामने था, लेकिन उनका दिमाग वो टाइम पे पैनिक के आ रहे बाप रे ऐसा करके, तो उनको जो बचने का रास्ता मिल रहा था उस पर उनका ध्यान नहीं
गया. वेरी गुड सुहास, आई थिंक ही हैज मेड टू इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स, आई डिस्कस दैट. प्लीज गिव अ गुड क्लैप फॉर सुहास. इफ यू लिसन टू व्हाट सुहास सेड, द एक्चुअल केस, एंड trust me, you will not believe when I say this. One, panic was right. Second, the key word, that gentleman, well educated, he's been working in the same place for close to 3 years. He did not know where the emergency exit was. And now you can ask me, like, how is that even possible? हो सकता है, I'll tell you why, because I was also similar kind of a person. घर से निकलो, कैब या बस पकड़ो, ऑफिस पहुंचो, लिफ्ट, सेवेंथ फ्लोर, एट फ्लोर, गो, कम बैक, टेक लिफ्ट, कम बैक, कम डाउन, टेक take a rickshaw, come back to your place. That's what I used to do, that's what he did. So, उनको पता भी नहीं था कि होटल या उनके ऑफिस में एक दूसरा एस्केप रूम भी होता है विच इज यूज इन केस ऑफ फायर इंसिडेंट और फायर एस्केप एंड इन फैक्ट आई नॉट पीपल आर पीपल वॉट कम हियर वर्किंग इन बैंक्स वर्किंग इन अदर प्लेसेस स्टूडेंट्स एंड हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव एक्चुअली ट्राइड टू एक्सप्लोर इवन इट वुड बी योर सोसाइटी योर ऑफिस do you know whether there is an evidence secret? That is question one. Yeah? Ask yourself. If you know, second, have you ever tried using that? Pata chala wo band pada hoga. Log bolte hain ki ek exit hai, but wo taala laga hoga ya fir apne wo accessible nahi hoga. So next thing when you go in your workspace, I suggest explore. Yes, Suhas? Exactly. So that is one way of doing it. It's a good practice. Most good companies do it. 3 months or 6 months, they make a mock drill. What they do is they do a pause for long and they see कितने time में हो रहे हैं सारे employees नीचे आए हैं इकट्ठा हुए हैं सब आए कि नहीं हैं उनको the whole idea is in case of an emergency कैसे react करते हैं so first take away from the story one is आपको know your surroundings या मैंने से know your surroundings be wary of your escape route emergency exit कहाँ पे for example I'm in this building मेरा अगर कुछ होता है यहाँ पे हादसा फर्स्ट मेरा एग्जिट कहाँ से होगा कहाँ से मैं निकल सकता हूँ सेफ एरिया कहाँ पे होगा राइट माय सेकंड स्टोरी मैंने बोला था कि अगेन एवरीबॉडी गॉट इंजर्ड एक्सेप्ट फॉर वन फैमिली ऐसा क्या किया होगा उन्होंने कि उनको कुछ हुआ नहीं है दे वर सेफली बैकवर्ड बट अदर्स वर दे वर अनकॉन्शियस दे वर टेकन टू हॉस्पिटल एंड दे वर हॉस्पिटल क्या हुआ ऐसा क्या उन्होंने सही किया कि वो लोग बच एनी गेसेस यस अजय
सो आई थिंक दे वर अवेयर ऑफ द सेफ्टी मेजर्स टू बी टेकन लाइक प्रोबब्ली इन केस ऑफ वन इमरजेंसी एग्जिट्स टू हाउ टू कीप योरसेल्फ अवे फ्रॉम स्मोक or fire or which kind of clothes to wear while exiting on these kind of things.
Very good, yeah, good. Give a round of applause to Jay. In fact, he was very right. The key answer is, they knew what to do in case of an emergency. Now, this is a slightly different case. आपको पता है emergency exit कहाँ पे है, आपको पता है कि आपको stairs लेना है, lift नहीं लेना है, in case of an emergency, क्यों? Emergency में the first thing the fire brigade comes they switch off the cut the electrical supply because so that वो electrical fire में ना
short circuit
ना दे short circuit ना हो जाए they cut the electrical supply okay no they know this process but still आप ऐसे situation पे आप क्योंकि you can get stuck where you cannot go for example hotel room में you cannot go out into the lobby क्योंकि वहाँ पे already आप फंस चुका है ठीक है so in that case आप क्या कर सकते हैं The family did nothing. When they did nothing, they knew what to do. They only had to wait till the fire brigade had to rescue them. So, उनको अपनी जान बचानी थी सिर्फ next 10-15 minute के लिए, जब तक उनको rescue हो जाए. Now, second question, how do I save myself? बाहर आग है, मुझे safe रहना है until somebody comes, break opens, और मुझे यहाँ से नीचे निकले. What do I do? मेजर रिस्क क्या है फायर से आप बता सकते हो मेजर में फायर एक्सीडेंट होते हैं सॉरी ओके वन मोर एनी अदर
लैक ऑफ ऑक्सीजन ड्यू टू स्मोक
एग्जैक्टली सो मेजर फायर एक्सीडेंट्स में स्टैटिस्टिक्स से पीपल डोंट डाई बिकॉज ऑफ फायर इंजरीज या फायर बर्न पीपल डाई बिकॉज ऑफ नो ऑक्सीजन बिकॉज स्मोक स्मोक के कारण ज्यादा एक्सीडेंट होते हैं फायर Typically, yes, yeah. The reason is again smoke. I'm connecting. यहाँ पे where a blind person has an advantage. I'll tell you why. आपको smoke होती है room में. People get panicked क्योंकि पहला first thing कुछ दिखाई नहीं देता. स्मोक का नेचर क्या होता है, पहले इट फिल्स योर पूरा एंटायर रूम स्पेस फिल करता है, देन इट कम्स डाउन, इट इज हेवियर देन एयर, सो बाद में नीचे आता है बट पहले इट रेजेस. नॉर्मल पर्सन फर्स्ट थिंग उसको सब कुछ पता रहता है, ओके वंस द रूम इज फिल्ड विद स्मोक, पैनिक सिचुएशन, ही इज नॉट एबल टू सी एनीथिंग एंड ब्रीदिंग स्मोक क्या होता है, यू कैन नॉट, आपने न्यूज में भी सुना होगा पीपल ट्राई जंपिंग आउट ऑफ बिल्डिंग्स, है ना, आपको लगता होगा कि ठीक है फर्स्ट फ्लोर सेकंड फ्लोर से कोई जंप कर सकता है तो ठीक है, बट 8th फ्लोर 10th फ्लोर 20th फ्लोर से भी जंप करके व्हाई वुड दे टेक दैट ड्रास्टिक स्टेप, आपको लगता होगा बहुत इडियोटिक है, इसके कारण एक साइंटिफिक रीजन है क्या, व्हेन पीपल ब्रीद इन वो जो कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड आती है, कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड इज अ कल्प्रिट, व्हेन यू ब्रीद इन वो क्या करते हैं आपकी ऑक्सीजन सप्लाई को बंद कर देती है आपके ब्रेन में जाने में, उससे क्या होता है आप रैशनल डिसीजन नहीं ले पाते, जो भी आपका डिसीजन लेने की आपकी कैपेबिलिटी होती है वो कम हो जाती है, एंड हेंस यू विल थिंक ऑफ मे बी अगर मैं विंडो से कूद जाऊँ आई माइट सेव माई लाइफ, विच इज नॉट नॉट द केस, अगर आप 20th फ्लोर में होंगे तो आपको अपने आपको बचाना है तो आपको कूदना नहीं चाहिए, राइट. तो इन दिस केस केस नंबर टू उन्होंने क्या किया, व्हाट इज द फैमिली डू, दे डिड दिस, उन्होंने पहले द रूम गॉट फिल्ड विद स्मोक, दे क्रॉल लाइक बेबीज, जैसे बच्चे फ्लोर पे जब सीखते हैं चलना जैसे क्रॉल करके जाते हैं, क्योंकि नीचे लो लाइट एरिया में स्मोक फिल होती नहीं है रूम में, दैट इज वेन वहां पे आप उनको विजिबिलिटी रहती है, तो दे नो वेयर टू एक्ट, ओके. सेकेंड थिंग दे स्टॉप विथ स्मोक एंट्रिंग इन द रूम को थोड़ा बंद कर दिया, डोर स्टॉपर वहां पे ये जो बाथरूम्स और टॉयलेट्स रहते हैं तो यहाँ उनको दे सोक्ड इन वाटर, दे कवर देयर फेसेस एंड दैट्स हाउ दे स्टॉप स्मोक कमिंग इनटू द सिस्टम, इन देयर सिस्टम एंड इनटू द रूम, एंड ऑल दे हैव टू डू वाज वेट फॉर नेक्स्ट 10 मिनट्स, दैट्स इट, दैट्स ऑल इट टेक्स. इन द सेम केस अगर आपको आई टू रिलेट इट टू यू, दिस सिनेरियो, दिस चैलेंज ऑफ अननोन जो सडनली करा मुझे कुछ दिख रहा है, दैट इज अ चैलेंज यू फेस एंड यू आर केपेबल ऑफ टेकिंग दैट चैलेंज एंड यू आर केपेबल ऑफ, यू हैव लर्नड हाउ टू डील विद दैट काइंड ऑफ अ चैलेंज, सो दिस इज मोर ऑफ अ एडवांटेज ऑफ यू नो फॉर अ ब्लाइंड पर्सन टू रिएक्ट इन एन इमरजेंसी सिचुएशन वेयर पर्टिकुलरली द विजन गेट्स ब्लॉक्ड. व्हेन आई से इमरजेंसी मैं अभी तक फायर सेफ्टी के बारे में बोल रहा हूँ, आई गिव अनदर स्लाइट डायरेक्शन, इमरजेंसी कुड बी नेचुरल कैलामिटीज, इमरजेंसी कुड बी अ मेडिकल इमरजेंसी, करेक्ट. मेडिकल इमरजेंसी होता है तो द वन रूल दैट वी से मोस्ट ऑफ द कि आपको अपने मोबाइल फोन में हमेशा एक कॉन्टैक्ट आपको चेंज सेव करना है, विच इज उसको बोलते हैं आइस, ICE. किसी ने सुना पहले ये आइस का मतलब होता है इन केस ऑफ इमरजेंसी, दिस इज नॉट फॉर यू, दिस इज फॉर समबडी एल्स, अगर आप खतरे में या फिर मेडिकल इमरजेंसी मेडिकल असिस्टेंस रिक्वायर्ड होता है, एनी बडी फाइंडिंग योर फोन होप इट्स नॉट लॉक्ड, दे व्हाट दे डू इज दे सर्च फॉर अ कॉन्टैक्ट कॉल्ड आइस, विच मीन्स इन केस ऑफ इमरजेंसी दिस इज द नंबर यू शुड डायल, तो आप ऐसा सेव करो जो आपके कॉन्टैक्ट होगा, कुड बी योर ब्रदर, योर फ्रेंड हु इज एनी हेल्प. मैं 100 101 वो नहीं बोल रहा हूँ, दैट एनी वे पीपल विल डाय, दैट इज अ डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट, दिस इज पर्सनलाइज इन केस ऑफ इमरजेंसी नंबर, सो दैट इज वन थिंग आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट यू टू ऑल्सो यू नो डू एंड सेव वन नंबर विच यू थिंक शुड बी डायल इन केस ऑफ एन इमरजेंसी, ओके. या
विशाल ऑन द सेम लाइंस व्हाट आई हैव डन, one of you had suggested in our company. So I have saved my emergency number on my lock screen itself. So when my phone is locked and if the phone is locked, they can't access my contacts. So in that lock screen, it says this phone is being tracked. In case of an emergency, please dial this number. So अगर कोई चोरी करता है तो उसको डर लगता है कि हाँ दिस फोन इज बीइंग ट्रैक्ड, तो फोन ट्रैक हो रहा है और एमरजेंसी के केस में लॉक स्क्रीन पे ही मेरा नंबर वो एमरजेंसी नंबर दिख जाता है. दैट कैन बी ऑल्सो अ गुड ऑप्शन.
देर आर मेनी डिफरेंट वे. दिस इज वन ऑप्शन विच विशाल पॉइंटेड. आप वॉट एवर सूट्स यू बट द होल आइडिया इज आपके पास एक ऐसा नंबर होना चाहिए दैट इफ समबडी समबडी एल्स फाइंड्स इट दे कैन रीच आउट टू द पर्सन हु यू वांट टू बी ऑन. I wanted to touch briefly on natural calamities also, not getting in depth in detail. Most of the natural calamities aap action nahi le sakte. Only thing that you can do is be prepared. Kyunki ye cheeze aap prevent nahi kar sakte. Earthquake koi prevent kar sakta hai? No. Flood? No. The next thing is agar hota hai to aap kya kar sakte. Another example, earthquake also. टिपिकली मैं अभी तक आपको इवैक्यूएशन के बारे में बोल रहा था बट अगर आप कोई हाई राइज बिल्डिंग में होंगे और आपको लगता है कि अर्थक्वेक जैसा लग रहा है आपको द फर्स्ट थिंग व्हाट दे से इज डोंट पैनिक एंड डोंट ट्राई टू रन और मूव आउट ऑफ द बिल्डिंग. वो कभी भूखा नहीं क्योंकि जब आप सीढ़ियां उतर के नीचे जाके आते हो तब तक के लिए पूरा बिल्डिंग मिल जाएगा. अर्थक्वेक यू फाइंड द स्पॉट आपको लगता है कि आप सेफ और अंडर द टेबल अंडर द स्टेयरकेस एंड वेट इट आउट. इन केस अगर आप बिल्डिंग के बाहर हो तो बिकॉज बिल्डिंग गिर सकते हैं तो यू हैव टू मूव अवे फ्रॉम द बिल्डिंग विच इज गो टू द नियरेस्ट मिडिल ऑफ द रोड अबटमेंट से अवे फ्रॉम द बिल्डिंग. सो दैट इज वन एस्पेक्ट. आई एम नॉट एडिंग मच बिकॉज दीज आर नेचुरल कैलामिटीज वी आर टॉकिंग इट कैन नॉट बी प्रिवेंटेड. Flood example, may again there is a very good point where I can connect with you, or rather you can find more lines. Floods may, if you see, there was one news article sometime back. One person lost his life because he fell into a manhole. Because it was over flooded, pura pani tha waste level tak. Again, he couldn't see, and in that situation. आप रस्ते पे जा रहे हो या कहीं पे आप अटके हो या फिर आप जा रहे हो वहां पे पूरा बंद पड़ा है पानी से एंड दैट पर्सन लेट्स सी नाउ पर्सन गेट्स पैनिक अगेन. जो उनको पता है नोन टेरिटरी बिकम्स अननोन सडनली. इन द सेम सिचुएशन इफ आई डोंट ड्रॉ एन एनालॉजी ब्लाइंड पर्सन विल नेवर फेस अ चैलेंज विल नेवर फेस एन इश्यू ट्रीटिंग और सीइंग अ नोन टेरिटरी एज अननोन टेरिटरी बिकॉज दैट इज That is your everyday challenge that you face and you overcome. आपके हाथ में गेम है. That is two steps ahead of you in every walk, right? That itself will prevent you. Most likely you will never fall into a manhole compared to any person अगर कुछ flat में हो रहा है because he is not able to see. And we are not process oriented because हमारे surroundings का जो आपके दिमाग में mental map होता है that is brilliant. And that will another interesting aapko bolna that is another you know advantage when you will lead actually you don't have to rely on somebody else in fact people will rely on you in such a situation because they know you can safely jo hoga whatever it matters you will safely reach let me follow this lady. Yeah everybody with me.
So I experienced an earthquake up close next to Calcutta. This was in 2017 or 2016 January, Calcutta was having frequent tremors. The issue for a blind person is that once the ground starts shaking, right, your sense of direction goes by haywire. You know, so even if you want to move to a safe place, try to move. But because the beneath your feet is shaking, your sense of direction is nowhere. That was tricky. It was damn tricky. So I mean, I don't know. It's very scary. But that actually impact because we rely on our tactile, like, you know, directional sense based on tactile. So that was tough.
Thanks for sharing. Actually, yeah, experiences like this should actually prompt you to be ready in case of a situation. Now, if that's your first experience. You will definitely are not prepared. Hence, I'm saying, you know, have something in the back of your mind. anything happens, okay, where is my nearest exit, where is my safest place? I'll come back to this same question in the same area when we talk about safety at home, where more preparedness is required. So I'll come, which actually I'll start with the same topic itself. We spoke about the fire safety and emergencies. One last finishing note I would like to tell you. First, we spoke about preparedness, that's a key takeaway. Second, we spoke about in case you are stuck, aap kaise aap bahar nikal sakte ho, aapko kya precautions lena hai. Worst scenario, agar aap you are caught on fire, ki aap aapke shirt and trousers, aapke kapde aap pakad lete hain and you get panicked. Another simple ek three word formula bolta hai iske liye, typical in industry. They say stop, drop, roll. इसका मतलब है स्टॉप पैनिकिंग फर्स्ट. आपको आग लगी है आपके ऊपर, यू आर ऑन फायर, ओके, स्टॉप पैनिकिंग. ड्रॉप, व्हेन आई से ड्रॉप, यू ड्रॉप ऑन द फ्लोर. व्हाई? क्योंकि आग, इफ यू सी द नेचर ऑफ फायर, इट इज ऑलवेज ग्रोइंग अपवर्ड, राइट. ऊपर जितना आप खड़े होते हो तो आप पूरा सरफेस है, आप पूरा आपकी लेंथ ऑफ बॉडी दे रहे हो आग को ऊपर जाने के लिए या फिर बढ़ने के लिए. So the second keyword is drop, which means stop everything, drop on the floor. And third keyword is roll. Roll karna hai aapko. And typically rolling, or you would have seen, ya fir aapne suna hoga ki people getting blankets and covering people when there is no water or anything. Isse kya hota hai, aapka oxygen supply to the fire cut hoti hai jab aap roll karte ho ya fir aapke upar blanket aate hai. And fire बनती है ये चीज़ में. One of the key things is oxygen. So when you stop, when you drop, and when you roll, what you're trying to do is you're extinguishing the fire on you. So please remember this. This is a simple technique: stop, drop, and roll. Yeah. And let me bring closer, even more. Safety at your home. मैंने जितनी जनरल बात किया है, let's say question, safety, the safety definition, जब हम start करते हैं, what do you mean by safety? तो मेरे तो textbook answer होता है इसके, you know your risk और hazard, which means basically जिससे आपको खतरा हो सकता है आपके health के लिए या फिर property के लिए, when you identify and take measures कि उस आपको किसे बचना है, that is basically called safety. Now my question to everyone, आपके हिसाब से आपके घर पे what are those risks या फिर hazards? It could be a dangerous situation, it could be anything. आपके हिसाब से क्या है जो आपके घर पे आपको लगता है कि उससे शायद खतरा हो सकते हैं, and hence I have to be prepared.
Short circuit.
Okay, well, good.
Gas leaks,
very good. Both of them should get chocolates. Very good.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. And what else? Very good point. Yeah. So we are talking about escape route, having grills, locked out situations. We are talking about electrical short circuit, and one gentleman had suggested gas leak. Yeah, I'll take these two because these are one of the top three risks at home. Abhi main risk bol raha to, I might say my wife is also there with me here. She is a risk to me if I don't act properly. That's that aside, that is the biggest risk for any family member, so for maybe it's me. But in general, safety aspect, mein, one, I'll go top three. One is very good, what I suggested, electrical short circuit. Okay, now, electrical short circuit, main issue kya hota hai? Most of the reasons on electrical, the problem is, it will start as an electrical shock.
एंड इलेक्ट्रिकल से वहाँ पे वायर जल जाती है, स्पार्क्स आते हैं एंड इट टर्न इनटू फायर बिफोर यू नो इट. सो दैट इज मेन द बैड पार्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल से. तो अनदर क्वेश्चन, तो हाउ डू वी टैकल दिस? शॉर्ट सर्किट बोल रहे हैं हम, लीक होता है कुछ कुछ इक्विपमेंट, आप टच करेंगे तो आपका इलेक्ट्रिकल शॉक लगता है, करेक्ट? जिनका मेंटेनेंस नहीं होता है या फिर वायर का कुछ शॉर्ट सर्किट हो, हाउ डू यू प्रिवेंट? इसके लिए ओल्ड डेज यूज टू कॉल फ्यूज, बोलते हैं जब फ्यूज हो जाती है वोल्टेज का वो लोड ज्यादा होता है, फ्यूज हो जाती है. आजकल अभी MCB RCD बोलते हैं, MCB इज योर सर्किट ब्रेकर, करेक्ट, सर्किट ब्रेकर. तो फर्स्ट थिंग अगेन, आपको लगता है कि इलेक्ट्रिकल शॉर्ट सर्किट हो रही है किसी इक्विपमेंट में, कुछ वायर होने के चांसेस है, या फिर व्हाट यू डू इज यू हैव टू स्विच ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट ब्रेकर, ECB जो होते हैं, MCB. And the second question, अच्छा तो आपको पता है कहाँ पे आपके घर में? Find out main supply, electrical supply. Even for a rescue fire tenders जब आते हैं, the first thing building society के दे last where is electrical mains and the switch off. घर पे भी अगर कुछ incident ऐसा होने का chances है, first what? Okay, where is my main supply? Where is my circuit breaker? Fuse. के बाद जो भी होगा, तो आई स्विच दैट ऑफ, राइट? वन. सेकेंड, टिपिकल टेंडेंसी होती है, जस्ट वन पिक पॉइंट, व्हेन यू मूव अराउंड, यूजुअली एक यूजुअल सिनेरियो देता हूँ मैं आपको, यू ट्राई टू चार्ज योर मोबाइल फोन, करेक्ट? आप क्या करते हो, यू ट्राई टू सर्च फॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल प्लग सॉकेट जो भी है, राइट? तो हो सकता है, आई एम गिविंग अ वर्स्ट केस सिनेरियो, हो सकता है स्विच इज ऑलरेडी ऑन एंड देयर इज ऑलरेडी अनदर प्लग विच इज हाफ इंसर्टेड, विच मीन्स हाफ ऑफ इट इज ओपन. तो अगर वो एक्सपोज है, अगर आप प्लग रखना चाहते हो, आप फिंगर से आप कोशिश कर रहे हो, तो आपको शॉक लग सकता है. तो सिंपल वे अगेन, इट्स अ मोस्ट कॉमन सिनेरियो, अगेन मोस्ट सिंपल आंसर. I was talking to this again, Shalini Diver, on this software question. Simple again. When you want to search for a plug, why not hold a, you know, aapke paas jo plug insert karna chahte ho, usi se aap, not with your bare fingers, a plug ke saath aap you approach, you try to explore. And aapko pata chal jayega ki wahan pe already ek plug hai ki nahi. But before, switch off. Right? Switch, you know, uske left ya right mein bagal mein jaise pe you have switches, switch it off.
That I have to share.
There is another socket next to that socket. Yeah. So generally what happens is sockets are in one line and then you have buttons below it or above it. So if the person is new to that place, might be in and that's a risk.
I'll come back to this. This is a good scenario which you all can come up with answer. I'll put my opinion on this. Yes, Ajay.
So there is a real life scenario there. In one of our residential places, quite early when we were young, so the electricity meter got fire, and so one wise thing which my mother did, and she even quite heroically recounts it today as well. So it was firing, and there was no way for her to touch the fuse, because otherwise it could have been dangerous. So those fuse, like in earlier days, they used to be like you touch and they go down. So how did she manage to do it? She had a broomstick which had a metal bar at one end and the another usual broomstick material at the other end, bamboo material. So she kept the bamboo material in her hand so that the shock does not transfer, and from the metal part she touched that fuse and she brought that down.
Very good. Yeah. See, there is no single rule for you know, all scenarios. You have to approach it case by case. So one gentleman said that there could be multiple plugs and there could be a new situation, not aware of this, it could be a challenge. Agreed. But again, you should have that sense of innovatively, creatively thinking or you know, approach based on the situation. I would like to throw a small point here. One of the incidents, again, I'll tell you, this is a medical case. टिपिकली जब somebody किसी को वो झटका लगता है ना, इलेक्ट्रिक शॉक जब झटका लगता है तो क्या होता है, बेसिकली आपके नर्व्स ब्रेन पे उसका इफेक्ट होता है एंड फर्स्ट रिएक्शन होता है आप यू ट्राई टू होल्ड योर फिस्ट करेक्ट, आप जो भी चीज पकड़ो हैंड्स वो डेंजर हो जाता, डेंजरस हो जाता है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल ये जो मैंने माइक पकड़ा या फिर आप आयन कर रहे हो, आयन कर रहे हो माइक पकड़ा हो, अगर इस इक्विपमेंट में कुछ इलेक्ट्रिक शॉक लगता है आई होल्ड ऑन इट, मैं इसको छोड़ूंगा नहीं क्योंकि वो शॉक मुझे इसे फोर्स कर देते कि मैं इसको छोड़ देता हूँ, क्योंकि ऑल माय बोन्स या फिर मेरे जॉइंट्स हैं वो सब दे गेट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एम्बल इशू जब आता है तो दे नॉट बी एबल टू रिलीज. सो वन टिप व्हाट दे से इफ यू वांट टू सी टिपिकली मिस्टेक क्या करते हैं लोग बोलते हैं कि अरे ये सुनना ये स्टैंड में से मुझे लग रहा है कि इसमें से थोड़ा इलेक्ट्रिक शॉक लग रहा है, एक बार देखना टच करके. तो व्हेन यू फर्स्ट थिंग इट्स अ वेरी लॉजिकल एंड सिंपल थिंग टू सी विद योर टचिंग विद योर बेयर हैंड्स. सेकेंड, अगर गलती से एक सिनेरियो दे रहा हूँ आप जा रहे हो आपको इन केस यू फाइंड आपको लगता है कि मैं कुछ ऐसे कॉन्टैक्ट में आ सकता हूँ किसी चीज से जो आपको शॉक दे सकती है, यू शुड क्लोज योर फिस्ट टुवर्ड्स योरसेल्फ, मतलब नकल्स एंड ऑल, क्योंकि इन केस अगर आप टच भी कर दो यू आर नॉट होल्डिंग इट क्योंकि आपके बैक ऑफ योर हैंड से वो कॉन्टैक्ट हुई है. At least you will not be holding it forever till after so it will get aggravated. You okay? The color of the screen. So yeah. Okay. So what I mean to say is, अगर आप जैसे किसी को temperature आप देखते हो forehead में हाथ रख के आपके knuckles contact में रहते हैं, correct? Back of your hand. अगर आप वैसे आप किसी इक्विपमेंट को बाई मिस्टेक भी आपने टच किया तो वो आप ट्विस्ट या फिर आप इस क्लोज करते हो तभी वो इक्विपमेंट आपके हाथ में नहीं आए, बट अगर आप अदरवाइज आप करते हो जैसे रोड स्टिक पकड़ा आपने, क्रिकेट बैट पकड़ते हो आप, गेम पकड़ रहे हो तो आप पकड़ते ही वो वैसे ही आप पकड़ते रह जाते हैं जब तक वो इलेक्ट्रिक सप्लाई खत्म ना हो, तो उसके रिवर्स में आपको अप्रोच होना चाहिए
जैसे इलेक्ट्रिक का जो प्लग होता है उसके प्लास्टिक का एक तो चीज होता है सेम उस मकड़ के शेप की, अगर वो स्विच यूज के लिए सीधा वो लगा के रखते हैं उसके ऊपर.
आई एम नॉट टू श्योर आप व्हाट यू मीन, व्हाट आई एम गेसिंग इज कुछ ऐसे सॉकेट्स रहते हैं जो चाइल्ड प्रूफ आजकल आ रहा है जो डॉक्टर मतलब लगे closing down with the last topic for the day. See, we only spoke about emergency, safety at home, electrical path. Yeah. In fact, let me finish because we were talking about gas leaks. Abhi, now the issue is, this typically kitchen environment. Mein hota hai. I don't know, most of the places have got that gas line, but still, some places have still cylinders coming in.
Yes.
Yeah? तो फर्स्ट थिंग यहाँ पे एनी इंसिडेंट रिलेटेड टू गैस लीक्स और गैस फायर सबसे मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज यू हैव टू बी वेरी 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 ऑफ सराउंडिंग यूजिंग योर सेंसेस विच इज योर स्मेल एंड सो वन इज द स्मेल. ये जो टिपिकल आपके एलपीजी कुकिंग है वो जो आपको स्मेल आता है दैट इज नॉट एक्चुअली दैट इज एडेड.
यस एग्जैक्टली
दैट इज एडेड सो दैट आपको पता चले कि इनके अंदर कुछ लीक होता है तो ये मेरा कुकिंग गैस का या एलपीजी का वो लीक हो रहा है, करेक्ट? दैट इज वन. एंड अगर आप ध्यान से नेक्स्ट टाइम आप मे बी यू यू कम अराउंड दैट सिचुएशन आप सुन सकते हो देयर इज अ नॉइज. अगर आप बर्नर को आप ओपन रख लेते हो
तो वन आपको आपको वो स्मेल से आपको पता चलता था गैस इज लीकिंग. सेकेंड एक थोड़ा सा एक स्लाइटली हिसिंग साउंड भी आता है बर्नर से एंड इट इज ऑन. Notice it, probably we miss out, but there is some sound that is okay. Third, obviously the surroundings itself. Ho sakta hai kisi ne kuch kala paka ke wahan pe they have left it open. So it is continuously burning. So obviously the heat and it might lead to another incident, but aapko you have always have to keep in mind on the smell, on the sound and the surroundings temperature, but we have nothing in that scope. Kitchen is one crucial place, important place, risky place. Last item, again, agar if I have to connect kitchen, aapke ghar mein you would probably be using some chemicals. Examples? Pesticides, insecticides, rat kill, cockroach marna hai, hit maro, bathroom clean kar raha hai, acid wo, jo bhi aata hai, wo use karte hai. So, these are dangerous goods, typically dangerous goods matlab which can again cause inflammable. Very good point. Some more, I'll not say more, but some of them are inflammable which can catch fire. Aur aap dekhoge typically households mein, in fact mere khud ke ghar mein ye jo poisonous cheeze hoti hai pesticide insecticide kahan pe milta hai? Mere kitchen mein hi milta hai. Ek jagah hoti hai, my mom has a बर्नर के नीचे एक ड्रॉअर एंड कैबिनेट वाला एंड दैट इज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट वी शुड नॉट डू बिकॉज़ दिस इज पॉइजनस सब्सटेंसेस. उसको आप सजेशन इज नॉट टू हैव एक डेजिग्नेटेड एरिया रखो आप बट नॉट इन द किचन बिकॉज अगेन वो फायर का भी प्रोटोकॉल भी है और जेंडर में ना सेट करेक्ट आप लोग भी करती है ये मोस्ट ऑफ दीस पीपल्स हैज अल्कोहल कंटेनमेंट बाथरूम क्लीनर्स हो या फिर दीस आर डेंजरस सब्सटेंसेस. तो आपको ये पता होना चाहिए कि गलती से भी अगर एक जगह पे रखना चाहिए दूसरे जगह पे आ गया है वो बाय मिस्टेक स्पिल हो सकता है गिर सकता है. तो यू हैव टू बी वेरी 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 आपके मेंटल मैप ऑफ योर होम प्लीज मेक पॉइंट ये चीजें कहाँ पर रखते हैं इंश्योर इट डजंट गो आउट ऑफ दैट प्लेस. सो दिस इज आई थिंक दिस कैन दिस This is part of the safety at home topic. Last point I want to touch is on road safety and the road user. Now this is again very unique safety aspect. I think Suhas from the beginning had said 50-50 responsibility. Yes, situation. क्योंकि अब तक मैं जो बोल रहा हूँ safety के related, वो आप कर सकते हो. आप preventive measures ले सकते हो. बट इट इज बाय रोड रोड की बात आती है तो यू आर नॉट अलोन. आप चाहे कितना भी प्रिपेयर करके जा सकते हो जाते हो यूज करते हो रूल फॉलो करते हो देर विल बी ऑलवेज एन इडियट हु इज जंपिंग द सिग्नल हु इज कमिंग आउट टू यू विद हाई स्पीड और हु इज ड्राइविंग के रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. तो इन दैट केस इट इज नॉट ओनली योर सेफ्टी दैट यू हैव टू वरी यू ऑल्सो हैव टू गेज दैट पर्सन यू हैव टू बी प्रिपेयर Somebody else's action. उसके खिलाफ से भी आपको चलना होगा. That is the sad fact. At least in India, rules आपको पता है कैसे होता है यहाँ पे ट्रैफिक में nobody follows. Follow करते हैं तो पीछे लोग चिल्लाते हैं अरे कोई नहीं तो ज्यादा भी क्या होता है. That is the situation. So I have only one or two points in this space where you can relate. I can say apart from let's say as a road user चल रहा हूँ आई एम यूजिंग दी रोड एंड आई हैव टू क्रॉस आई हैव टू गो फ्रॉम लेफ्ट हैंड साइड टू राइट हैंड साइड टिपिकली आई एम अस्यूमिंग दैट यू नो यू विल बी यूजिंग योर केन ऑल्सो यू रेज योर केन रेज योर हैंड सो दैट द ऑनकमिंग ट्रैफिक नोस ठीक है फाइन ओके यू टेक योर टाइम टू एसेस मतलब आप टाइम लेते हो कि ओके ट्रैफिक हैज कम टू अ स्टॉप नाउ इट इज सेफ फॉर मी टू वॉक आई गो. But my one point here is, you take as much time as you want, you assess the situation, and then don't hesitate. So when if you want to, you're trying to move, make a move, you go for. Don't hesitate, so that the user
road users are the driving oncoming vehicles or traffic, they don't feel that I am looking at somebody, I don't know who is going to stop or who is going to proceed. Is he taking left or is he taking right? So obviously this is not for only you, this is for the traffic also, the driver who is approaching or the biker who is approaching. If you hesitate, you will also be confused. Typically, many situations I can tell you in my own life also, two, three karke road cross karte hain. And imagine that how difficult that is. मैं किसी का हाथ पकड़ता हूँ, मैं तो रोड क्रॉस करने जाता हूँ, मुझे लगता है कि वो व्हीकल आने से पहले मैं क्रॉस कर दूंगा, मेरे दोस्त को लगता है कि वो क्रॉस नहीं कर पाएगा, मैं इसको खींचता हूँ, वो मुझे खींचता है, दोनों बीच मिडिल ऑफ द रोड गेट स्टॉप, और बाइकर को भी समझ में नहीं आता कि हम लोग आ रहे हैं कि जा रहे हैं. तो ऑल थ्री ऑफ अस गेट स्टक एक ही पोजिशन पे बिकॉज ऑफ द होल कंफ्यूजन. तो हैंस टेक योर टाइम बट हेजिटेट मत कीजिएगा, यू प्रोसीड. एंड लास्ट आइटम अगेन यू माइट से कि हम लोग ये वाई शुड बी हैव दिस सेफ्टी मेजर, बट ट्रस्ट मी रोड सेफ्टी इज लाइक दैट. अगर आप उनके लिए दूसरों के लिए क्यों करना है, इट हैज टू बी. व्हाट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट इज पर्सनल प्रोटेक्टिव इक्विपमेंट बोलते हैं, पीपीई इन जनरल. रोड के मामले में आउटसाइड वेस्टर्न कंट्रीज में इट्स ऑल वेरी पॉपुलर विद चिल्ड्रन एंड लाइट लो लाइट सिचुएशन. What they do, what they suggest is there are certain types of vests जो light के type के fluorescent होते हैं, self reflective होते हैं. You know they give you whenever there is a light oncoming traffic का जो light आपके ऊपर पड़ती है, they reflect. So basically it's not for you, it's for the biker, it's for the vehicle who's coming, and it is to tell them that you know there is a person who is there. And typically even, see I am from a courier industry, FedEx, and lot of us couriers are also given these jackets. Kyunki jab courier delivery dene jata hai road pe, one of the rules that we have is the no light condition, he has to wear that kind of jacket so that people see him. It's for his safety, but it is meant for somebody to notice that he is there. So self-reflective jackets or clothing equipment, badges, there are many things. Helmets pe ek strip lagate hain, bikes pe lagate hain, jo chalte hain unke bags pe lagate hain. So these are some points you can remember. On a closing note, you know, and then I'll probably leave some time for the discussion. I was talking to Vishal, you know, like how do I conclude, and then I disappear on the topic. One thing is, when you speak about as a road user, mobility and you're using the road or walking, your mobility skills are the primary, the most important skill that one needs to have. And there are different ways nowadays, it's a skill, it's an acquired skill. Aap usko develop kar sakte, there are many different ways of techniques ke saath kar sakte, or you can learn technology coming in. The key is practice, and my only request is you get it from a very good NGO or good or people who have done it, who can explain it to you better. Once you practice and improve your mobility skills, and that will help you, and you don't have to rely on others you know, for safety aspects on the road. So that's it from my end. If I give a total like takeaway, like an event or telling we discussed about the whole the key point of safety is have that knowledge, because with knowledge you know what risks you are dealing with, and once you know what risks you are dealing with, you know how to be prepared, and what it takes is only it's a matter of time that you practice and you get yourself prepared for it.
I was just noting whatever came into my mind while I was talking. have 3 points. One, Vishal also spoke about the phone locking in return. Because even on my phone, without my configuration, I will not be able to, nobody else can start the phone. So maybe you must have not thought about it, or maybe you have some idea about mental that. But Vishal was saying something, so I just wanted to know exactly what he wanted to say about how to, you know, make that one particular number available for others to have good idea. Second question is about my residence right now. It is on the ground floor. And what I noticed is that the electrical meters and the pin switches and all these things are at a very low level. And during the rains, it was like a lot of water which was, you know, rising up towards that particular level. So obviously switching them off is one option. But is there anything else that we can consider, or is it, and even if we switch everything off, is it safe? Because power is still coming to at least to that point. And then you switch it off. So the mains are already on. That's the second question. The third question is that I have not understood what was your reply about the gas leakage. So once that gas starts leaking, what are the things we should do and shouldn't do during that time? Maybe I've not heard it properly, maybe you have replied.
Thanks for the question. I'll take it from 3 to 1. The first question on gas leakage, I think we moved from another topic. I was about to close that one. So what do you do when like you notice and you come to know that there is a gas leakage? That's the question. So please understand, so the of all the fires, solids catching fire, liquids catching fire, gases catching fire, gases are the most dangerous because they spread fast and they are very quick. And before that happens, what you have to do is ventilate. That is the only way. Of course, first you switch off the source, and that source could be your LPG or the gas connection. Second, you open the windows, let the gas go, ventilate, and go, let the gas dissipate. Before catching. And now the other continuation question is, let's say you are cooking something hot oil, that catches fire. Again, you don't have to panic. And if there is a gas cylinder, normally, when I say normally, most of the cases, they don't explode like people usually think, because they are subjected to a lot of mess. And you know how they are carried, they are just rolled on the floor, they are thrown on the floor. They don't usually explode. But for something that catches fire, which is your dish or something, again, wet cloth, put it on the dish or the container which caught fire. So it will douse for certain time and then you can unless it has oil, something different. You cannot pour water on the oil because they don't mix. Water, अगर आप तो कभी आप पानी डालते हो तो और ज़्यादा बेहतर, क्योंकि वो मिक्स नहीं होता है. ऑयल्स के लिए फायर एक्सटिंग्विशर ओनली वे जो आप यूज कर सकते हो, अनलेस छोटा मोटा फायर एक्सटिंग्विशर क्लॉथ भी ओके, बट यू कैन नॉट पोर वाटर. सो वाटर इज नॉट एक्चुअली अ मेन आपके एक्सटिंग्विशर मीडिया के ऊपर इलेक्ट्रिकल फायर. सो इलेक्ट्रिकल फायर में भी अगर आप पानी आप डालते हो, फायर नहीं पड़ेगी, बट आपका इलेक्ट्रिकल शॉप पर लगे हुआ. तो दैट इज ऑल. नो, फॉर ऑयल अनफॉर्चुनेटली एनीथिंग दैट वी यूज इन हाउस, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट बिगर फायर. ऑल द फायर दे गो ऑन द टॉप, यू कैन पुट इट आउटसाइड और यू कैन गो आउट एंड कॉल द हेल्प. बट दैट इज समथिंग, नो, वी कंसेंट शुड हैव फायर एक्सटिंग्विशर विच इज वेरी वेरी इजी टू यूज. Your second question on the ground floor, yeah, so that again, see, I don't have the visibility, what I'm guessing. Please ensure that when I say switch off your mains, sometimes your three-phase, two-phase, one-phase, both of main doors are there. Ensure the mains are there, let's say, everything gets cut off. And once the mains supply is cut off, it's okay. There are a lot of the office, maybe, are looking. They have put water
switches are there, like what, under, on the floor at the computer.
Yes.
It was flooded completely. But nothing went bad, or they had cut down the electrical supply, and the school brought on it, dredged, yeah, to the Kali or whatever. There are different techniques to take care of. And first question on the phone log, correct, see we say as a practice you should have this as a contact, but what if now it's logged, you are not able to pull it out. Some phones has a feature of dialing that one number, which is the emergency number, but we also say it's not only your phone is most, this is least trusted lines. You can switch off also, it can go, you don't know what to do. The other thing is, what we do is we give keychains and we give like a ID card, on the back of it you can write, people usually put it in your wallets and things like that. So that is the hard way, or the hard copy we are doing it. One is storing key number. But to answer how do I do it, I think it's actually
so if you are using Android phone, you have options to enter your emergency details. You will find that in settings, user settings, under that you will see lock screen information, or under user settings you will see lock screen and then emergency. So in that you can put any message you want to. So that whenever somebody finds your phone, and when you are in an emergency and can't use the phone, they can see the information on your lock screen and do the necessary. So I don't know where you will find it in iPhone, but iOS also has this option. Thanks.
Thank you. One last question which is still there. Wet cloth, the way you said the wet towel used to go when there is smoke in the house. So how to use it? I didn't understand that.
Wet cloth is done in two instances. One, if there is room filled of smoke, you cover, it could be your handkerchief, it could be your piece of towel or blanket. You're covering your face so that the smoke, you're not breathing smoke. Yeah, just you're not covering to your nose or mouth at that level. So then it doesn't enter. Second instance I've said is, when let's say you're cooking something and you forgot about the dish catches fire, instead of throwing water and making it worse, you put a wet cloth on top of it. Again, it serves two purposes, that is reducing the temperature, cooling it down. Second, again, it cuts off the oxygen supply and hence the fire gets lost off. So when I say put the wet cloth, put it on the dish which has caught the fire, the food in the dish which has caught the fire. I think one gentleman has a question here. Yeah, yeah, you can. Whatever it takes. In fact, I attended a session, there was an ex-army person. He simply said, without going into much detail, he said, whatever you can, it's a matter of survival. If it comes to that, now you can use anything.
Case like I mean, somebody was staying opposite to our place, and that lady was alone at home. And she, there was a kadai, there was one vessel full of oil, and she was just warming it up to add some maybe pakora or whatever. That entire thing caught fire. It was like rising like 3 feet above the thing. So that time, what like when you say wet cloth, so should we? Wet hand towel which is thick enough and put it on that vessel which is having fire. That time we had emptied a flower pot or something like that, and then we put mud on that. So that time we put.
The thing is, mud and sand usually works for ground level surface fire, but oil is very tricky. It depends on
take a call on that situation. But burn, yeah, you can do that. See, that's what I'm saying. You have to take judgment is very crucial. If you think it is still within your hand, it's not spreading, a little bit isolated. Okay, let it simmer down and let it cool down. Not water, but wet towel or not.
इसीलिए पूछा था ग्लव्स और होल्डर्स के बारे में. बच्चों की उंगली जा सकती है, इवन ब्लाइंड आदमी की भी जा सकती है ओपन ग्लव्स या होल्डर्स में. तो उसके लिए मैंने देखा है कि अपने जगह जगह पे ऐसे शोपीस आते हैं जिसमें आप लगा के जा सकते हो, जो जीरो पावर देता है, तो उससे भी आप सेव कर सकते हो. काफी शोपीस आते हैं जिसको ग्लव्स और होल्डर्स होता है, इसके की भी टेंशन उसके भी ऊपर. दैट
इज अगेन अ गुड सजेशन. शोपीस और they are dummy plugs, basically. Yeah, dummy plugs, you can use them.
Hey, I have a question. Now, electricity, now we don't know people are coming from where they just go and do your mechanic thing, wires and everything. What is old? Are they certified? How do we come to know whether they are certified electricians or that? People can come which city where they are coming for work here in Mumbai. They don't know A to Z, just doing the work and doing the manual job. Sab acha hai. How to test whether trust the person, whether it AC wala comes or anybody. Installation person comes from different thing, and the person who delivers the system is a different thing. The company, because company sits from a different organization, different or Voltas or whatever it is, Samsung. So they are from the different holders. So it is an issue. And second thing, what are the technologies in the building when the building collapses and crashes? So what is the now method used in the building, new method, or that can be hold for 8.5 or 9 earthquake? So what is the new technology? Thank you.
My friends, recently I have also heard about new type of wire. When sir was talking about road safety, nowadays there is also a new issue that a car that is traveling on road suddenly catches fire. So if there is even a thumbnail chance of escape, how would it be? That is my question, because even though many of our people, we don't have our own cars, we travel in taxis or cabs or something. So that's my question. Thank you.
Okay. The first question on how can we judge whether the person who's at your home to do some electrical repairs. Honestly, there's no straight answer to it. Aapko, you know, maybe you can ask kitna experience the person ne kaam kiya hoga, but it is a very very subject to kaun aata hai aapke is pe. There is no India, there are no aap check kar sakte ho ya license hai uske paas ki aap aise use kar sakte ho. There are certain things which are very very which require some skills, jo government ke certificate se hota hai unka. But for typical simple cheeze, there's nothing which can help certify somebody. I think you can only ask, and you can ask around, and I think that is the only preventive approach. Second question, aapne pucha earthquake related. Earthquake new technologies are say design phase mein implement hota hai, when building materials lete hain, when the building design is made. The structure itself is built. And again, when I say design, it means that in which zone you live, zone 4, zone 5, zone 3, etc. If there are more chances, then the building is constructed as per certain requirements. Very specific, I'm sorry, so exactly it's too technical for me to discuss. Suhas, your question was vehicle catching fire, what do you do in that scenario, is that it? So, sorry.
Yes, fire the gaadi ko kabhi lag jaye to ek se do spare parts ke liye ek factor ko utar
sakte hain. Okay. again, now moving back in fire, two three incidents were with Tata Motors. We used to discuss incidents like this. First, rule of thumb, it's not your home or जहाँ पे आपको जाके fire fight करना है. So be cautious कि fire कहाँ से पकड़ी है. It could be interior, could be engine, but moving vehicle, which means first it has to be stopped. Do not panic. Try to move as much away as possible from the vehicle. इतना ही simple है. And you don't have to fire fight क्योंकि आपको पता नहीं है. And you don't have to indulge in fire fighting and take steps or anything. That's the only thing, because it can go to fuel tank and you can hardly do anything but save yourself. So get out of the vehicle and move away from it. So you have to respond in the situation. You are with the driver, you are with the person who has control that. Unlock it. Or it comes to your life and the situation, break the window. So all the questions that I have asked or you have asked me, my question to you back, all the questions that you asked me, who should be prepared with the answers? The other way of asking is, whose responsibility is your safety? Whose responsibility is it? It's your own responsibility. It's my responsibility that I am safe. It's my responsibility that I keep my family safe. It is everybody's responsibility that they ensure their own personal safety. I think with that note, I close my session. I really thank everybody for thank you so much.
There are very few who don't know Braille. I am one of them. I know partially. BrailleMe is a product which does interesting things with the latest technology that we all have. So it connects Braille with the modern technology. And to share about that, we have Mr. Tony Kurien. So Tony Kurien is doing his PhD from IIT Mumbai. He is doing his PhD in economics and finance, and he is representing a startup called Innovation Tech. So this product called BrailleMe is designed by Innovation Tech. Let's understand what it is. So let's welcome Tony Kurien.
The project of BrailleMe is to make Braille relevant and affordable, right? Now I also have Lakshmi. Lakshmi, can you say hi?
Yes.
Hi. So Lakshmi Sarkar has also worked with the team Innovation Tech at IIT. So he also will be assisting me. He will be following the instructions. Now I before the session we had circulated the device for all of you to get the hands-on feeling. I hope that is taken care of. So take one device. Sir, text me again. Right.
Yes.
So. Now, what I will do is I will run through the functionality of the device and I will simultaneously keep demonstrating. Now, remember that this is a tactile based device, so if device has no sound, it means I will only get the feedback from the device and lecture. But I will still try and run a demonstration. Right? So, the device, if you keep the sloping side of the device to you, on the top would be a Braille panel with 20 cells. Beneath the Braille panel, you have 20 corresponding what we call as cursor keys, and on the left top you have left up arrow and down arrow, and then there is a key at the bottom of left side. From left to right, if you move, there is 3, 2, 1, then 4, 5, 6, and a space bar as in a Perkins Braille thing which we have said here. On the right side, you have right up arrow and down arrow, and you have a key at the bottom of the right. That's the end. Okay, so I'm going to switch on the device. The device switch on is on the right face. I'm going to switch on the device. And the device is switched on. Now on the Braille panel, it shows menu. Before I start operating the device, in the box you get the BrailleMe device, an AC adapter charger, a USB cord, and a 8GB memory card which is already inserted to your device, which is on the left face of your device. Right? So I have switched on the device, now it shows menu, and I'm going to press enter, which is the right bottom key. The first item on enter on the menu is file manager, which we will enter. We'll go one by one in the menu. That's the sort of idea I have. With your permission, let me sit and talk, you know. So menu, and I'm on file manager right now. I'm going to enter again, right bottom key. Right, and now my first item in file manager is browse file. The second is search file, and the third is new file. So think about this as a Braille Microsoft Word. You know, that's the easiest way of, you know, picturizing this for you. So let me go to the browse file item. I'm going to enter on browse file. This device at present have two files in it. You know, so one file is for some transportation or something, and this manufacturer. BrailleMe takes in two formats. As of now, it takes in text files, your notepad format, also BRL, you know, BRL format. So two file formats right now are supported by BrailleMe. Let me enter the first file, the transport file. Right? I'm going to enter this. Okay. It says, "Me, do you want to open the file?" And we say, "Yes." Right? And once I open it, you have two modes in BrailleMe. One is read-only mode, where you can just read, and the other is edit mode, where you can read as well as text. Okay? If you are in the read mode, you can just, you know, use your fingers, you know, read over the Braille panel, and the file and then will be displayed on Braille. And if you want to move from one line to the other, down left key and right down arrow press karna hai, and the cursor will shift to the next line. Okay. If you are in the edit mode, right, you are going to, you can type, okay, and you can type like as if you are typing a Braille, you know, the Perkins Braille kind of typing. There is a functionality in BrailleMe that is while typing. The position where your cursor keeps blinking. Okay, it keeps going up and down and up and down. You can continue with that or you can stop this. There's a shortcut key which is back key plus three, but you know, right now I understand this shortcut key doesn't make any sense to you. But there's a shortcut key through which you can stop the cursor being blinking and you can continue that. Okay, now you will go out of this file. And it asks me to do yes or no, and there is a shortcut key for yes, which I'm going to press. So I have closed the file. Now I have two more options of delete file and rename file, which it works as you know it happens in the computer. So I'm not going to go through the details, right? Now below the browse file, you had search for files. So if you have multiple files in your device, you can press enter and you can type the name of a file, and you press enter, you know, it pops up the file list, right? If the type wants to match the file with us. Windows mein hota hai, the same system hai, sirf ye brain mein hota hai paas. And then there is definitely something called new file, then you can open this and then you can start typing. When once you open the Braille panel to display start typing, and you press your keypad and then you can type. That's your new file. Okay, and you can save the file. And remember, the file is saved on memory card. It is not saved on device, it's on memory card. So if you take out the memory card from the device, you put it on a PC, the PC may have a file. The next item in the menu is Bluetooth. So what happens in Bluetooth is that the idea is to connect your device with a mobile phone. There are two advantages for this functionality. One is that if you're a parent to a blind child, you can see what the child is doing on the Braille device, because you know your mobile will simultaneously pop up the things, what you know with Braille, right? The second functionality also is for bad students like me. You can use mobile phone in the class without relying on the books. So how to connect your mobile phone to the Braille device? I'll just give you a short description. So you need to go to the Bluetooth menu and you need to pick the pairing device. The first item in the Bluetooth menu is called pairing device. You press enter on that. I'm doing this. What it shows, waiting for a new connection, means waiting for pair request. After smartphone mein, you have to open your Bluetooth settings and you know then try and connect. So you should pop up BrailleMe and you then tap connect to BrailleMe and it will ask, it will wait for some time to get connected. What you need to do for Android users is that you need to go to Play Store, download something called Google Braille Pack. That is the TalkBack's partner for Braille.
Yes.
Download Google Braille Pack, and once your Bluetooth, once your smartphone is connected with your device, you need to go to Braille accessibility and turn on Braille Pack, and then the device automatically connects to the device automatically connects to the phone. Right. Now, couple of versions of Android is showing some technical difficulty in connecting to the device, but we are in the process of sorting it out. Android 7 with motor devices, which is unfortunately mine, is not getting connected. But iOS is, iPhone connectivity is in the process of development. Android, apart from one or two devices, let's say 99% of Android devices are right now covered. So once you connect the device with the phone, everything you do on your phone will be reflected on the device, and everything you do on your device will be reflected on the phone. That is essentially you can type on BrailleMe on your smartphone. That's the point. So I will come out of the menu, out of the Bluetooth. The next is called USB mode. So USB mode is this. The idea is to connect your Bluetooth, so connect your BrailleMe device with the computer. So what you do is you put in your there's a USB port with the device you get in the box. You connect one end to the computer, the other end to the device. And NVDA users, right now we have not yet figured out the support for JAWS, but we are in the process. For NVDA users, there is in the NVDA add-on page. You will find something called the BrailleMe add-on. You want to download the BrailleMe add-on and install it and activate it. Once you connect to the device to the computer using the USB code, and once you activate the connection by pressing enter the device, your computer would reflect everything you do on the BrailleMe device, and your BrailleMe device would reflect everything you do on the computer. That means you can type on your keyboard, computer keyboard, and have the Braille display shown for the simultaneously have the Braille display on the device. That is the idea behind USB mode, right? As of now, as I said, it's supported for NVDA, but those users will soon have their support. The next item is settings. Now there are multiple things that one is set language. As of now, BrailleMe provides support for a host of languages, but English and Hindi predominantly. So the point is that if your system language, if your device language is set in English, and if your memory card has files in Hindi, that will not be shown in the browse file, right? So be careful that your system language corresponds to the file which you want to read. The next is set time, is Fatu, you don't know how to do that. Set date is Dusra Fatu, you know how to do that. Okay, set auto score. This is a good, this is a very interesting, facility. Let's say that you are reading a big file and you don't want to press the down arrow key every time you want the device to move to the second, the next line, right? What you do is you set auto score time. The user can set it from 2 seconds to 9 seconds, or 2 seconds to 9 seconds. So after, let's say that you set auto scroll at 5 seconds, that's the default. After every 5 seconds, the next 20 cells will pop. Essentially, if you know what is your brain reading speed, आपको वाटर कोल्ड फायदा यू नो दैट्स द पॉइंट सो इट विल ऑटोमेटिकली स्क्रोल डाउन एंड यू कैन यू नो यू डोंट हैव टू बॉदर अबाउट स्किपिंग द नेक्स्ट लाइन एंड दैट इज द आइडिया ऑफ वाटर स्क्रोल एंड Now there is factory reset, which you know that when you are in trouble and stuff like that, software version of the point. Right, so these are the basic ideas in settings. Now I'll move to the next one, which is battery level. Now, how does BrailleMe display battery level, right? That's a good question. So, the first 10 cells will tell you, the first 10 cells in the Braille panel will tell you how much battery you have. If your battery is 100%, all the 10 cells would reflect 6 dots. Okay? If your battery is 90%, the last cell, the 10th cell would only have 2 dots. Right? And it would come down. If your battery is 50%, the 5 cells would have 2 dots, and so on and so on. When your device reaches 2% battery, it automatically shuts down without any notification. But, like any other smart device, this one will notify you when your battery is 15% and 10%. When it automatically shut down, it saves the work you have been doing. So yeah, that's the point. Now, then there is a, you know, then you can shut down it using the thing. Now I will move on to a couple of facilities that BrailleMe offers. One is that, so in Braille you know that there is Braille level, Braille 1 and Braille 2, by which we mean the one without contraction and one with contraction, right? So some of us are familiar and comfortable with contractions, some of us are not, right? So BrailleMe takes care of this situation. If you once you open a file, there is a shortcut key which is enter plus space bar plus back. That doesn't make any issue. You will be able to figure this out. Once you press that, if you are in non-contraction format, the BrailleMe device will automatically shift to the contraction and revert in the opposite hand. So you don't have to worry about the contraction thing, it will automatically shift. I mean it will shift according to your wish, right? So contraction is taken care of. Also editing is made easy using the cursor. So cursor is so corresponding in every Braille cell, there is a cursor. Okay. So if I want to type from cell 6 on the panel, I need to press the cursor in 6. Okay. Am I on the same page? Right. So let's say that I'm typing and I need to start from half of the line, you know, the mid of the line. Right. That means let's say I want to start from cell 10. So there is no, you know. There's no cursor per se, right? So how do you tackle it, right? So what you do is you get the 10th cursor key and press it, and the cursor will automatically shift to cell 10. So when you type from there, I mean when you type, the cursor will start typing from cell 10. That is the process. As of now, because the text file is supported, you don't have to have a BRL converter in your file. That means you don't have to have a software like Raspberry, which is very costly, in your computer so that you to get the files in Braille. We are in the process of making MS Word accessible. I mean MS Word, you know, being recognizable in BrailleMe. The battery charge will last you for 10 hours on one charge. And the device, as you did text, is pretty portable. The larger point is that it's an 8 GB memory card, so you can pretty much have a lot of files. That's not an issue. You can insert the memory card to your computer, like mostly these days you use laptops, to your laptop. And transfer the file from the laptop. So let's say that you want to read an email, right? You can transfer the email from your computer to the memory card and put it on the device, and you will get a Braille output for that. So you don't need to. I mean, that's a third point. You don't have to have Braille books. You can have a refreshable Braille display. So that is how it is conceived. These are essentially the features of Braille. The device is priced at 25,000, which is I understand that the lowest price, you know, that point in the market, because personally speaking, I wanted a Braille display device because I thought I'm relying too much on the on screen readers. And if you are a student or if you are a professional who want to do presentations, you really can't rely on screen readers because you cannot listen and present simultaneously. So I did try Braille device for my couple of presentations, and that is when I realized that Braille do have a lot of value, because there are things that screen readers really can't help us with. So what I do is, before this I had to, get a Braille printout, and Braille printers are, you know, are rare to find and costly to figure out. Once I figured out this device, I basically got my notes and put it in the Braille Me device, and I got the, you know, Braille display working for me. So presentations seems to be one of the important things where I figured out that Braille is of use. Note taking during lectures, so what I usually used to do, I used to put my Kindle and Bluetooth keyboard and take notes. That's how I used to do. The problem with that mode of note taking was that I could not instantly remember back. But taking note in the Braille, this device, Braille device, or any other Braille professional Braille display, helps you to instantly remember back while taking notes. So these two seems to be for me most important advantages of now, and it's pretty important. That's where Braille Me stands. Oh, by the way, the device, this company called Innovation, was started by two IIT students only. So they were doing some project during their engineering, and they figured out that this is something they want to work. So there's a big hi from Surimi and Sham, the founders of Innovation. They are right now in US, attending a conference, professionals conference, I'm right with the name. This device, it's a conference, it's an international conference on accessibility, one of the best international conferences on accessibility. And these guys got an award, which is called a Stretch of Genius Award, fancy name, but it's a credit to them that two people outside the disability sector came up and figured this device. So there are still a couple of glitches. For example, at times what happens is that one word is broken into two brain lines. So that kind of glitches right now exists a little bit. They are trying to fix it. So some formatting, some software jugaad is done so that a word doesn't get broken in two lines. That's it. I understand that ideal way of introducing this device should have been one-to-one interaction, but with all the constraints we are unable to do that. But let me know the kind of queries you have, and if anyone of you wants to come up here and ask me to text the device or figure out something on it, I'm more than happy to do that.
Tony, couple of questions. Hello. Yeah. So, first question is that is USB OTG supported on Android or on any smartphone?
Okay.
Is USB OTG supported? So, if say due to some reason I'm not able to pair the Braille display with the Bluetooth, right, using Bluetooth. On Windows, I can definitely connect it through USB. Yeah. That's fine. But can the device support USB OTG mode on an Android device?
As of now, it doesn't.
Okay.
The idea was to use. I mean, the idea of now is to connect it through Bluetooth. But so as of now, the device doesn't support OTG on phones, on smartphones. But that is something that these guys are considering, that Yongshin is considering doing, because like I said, in some devices, the Bluetooth was showing up some, you know, tricks in very rare cases, but that is definitely something that people are trying to like.
Another question which I have is, so is it possible to connect this device as a media storage device so as to the person does not have to eject the memory card, because few computers don't have memory card slots, and secondly, you may or may not be carrying a card reader always for those computers who don't have the slot.
Right. So the as of now we have not conceived this as a as a data storage device. This was the order, right? The new one, once you can directly do it from the computer, you don't necessarily have to insert the card into the computer. You can as well as connect and copy the file directly into the device. That's possible in the new version. The ones right now which is available, the version, this is possible.
Yeah, another question which I have is, the kind of feature updates that we get, so how does this device go on OTT? So if I buy this today and tomorrow if we get new features, like you were telling that there are a couple of glitches or there are a few functionalities which may be missing or which may be additionally added, so how are those addressed? How are the software updates delivered to the device, and how do we go about it?
Software updates are really available. You can download them from the Innovation Tech website, and whenever the new software updates are available, once you connect your device to your PC, USB, you will be notified about them, and then you can install those updates in the device. Did I answer you?
Yes.
Anything else?
Any other questions?
Okay, I'm getting a mic. Yes. My question is, how is the support, forget of smartphone or any phone, but you can connect to a PC also, means with a net, or how is the performance with the PC? And books which are there in Bookshare or Gutenberg, are they supported with your device? Or it's like Bookshare, Gutenberg, or Bakery Library. There are so many good books in their share. So are they supported? Have you tried using those books? Are your device reads music files or such type of thing? Are you developing any application in Microsoft Office? Word or Excel sheets, so this problem can be, how to see those things which are used daily by daily basis.
Then the same option of connecting this device to your PC and reading reading them on the Braille display here can be done.
Just to add to Lakshmi's clarification, so more and more formats, independent support for more and more formats, that is independent money, portable, like you don't have to connect the devices to the computer, but portable support for more and more formats are in the process. So right now it's for text and Braille, but soon we will have PDFs and Microsoft Word also available, so that you can get the copy of the file, a Word file or a PDF file from the computer to your to the device, and carry the device and have it at the Braille display. Because we understand that a lot of books do come in PDF and MS Word. So that is about to be.
Yeah, so Ajay here again. Another question is it possible to, I'm aware that this device is not currently used as a storage device as of now, but my, it's not a question so as to say a suggestion rather. So I would suggest we keep the functionality of playing audio files through it, so that because a lot of visually impaired people, especially when it comes to regional languages, the device can support Hindi, it can read Hindi books, but the Hindi books in an accessible format, say be it TXT, be it an accessible PDF or be it BRL, they are not readily available, they are mostly available in audio formats. So, if possible, the functionality of playing audio files should be added in the device, so that a visually impaired student can store all his or her books in the device and access those from the device itself. And secondly, those books which have direct DAISY content as well, so those can also, so there are full text and full audio DAISY books, even they can be taken care of. So that's how it can become a complete reading solution.
This was indeed discussed for the next set of development. The idea is to get into as many as formats which visually impaired people mainly like, so DAISY, and to some extent audio and stuff like that. So this is discussed, and this suggestion has come, and thank you for your suggestion. This suggestion came from other users too, and because these formats are important for people to visualize. So we are trying to get this done. But the present version doesn't have a facility, but this is something that the development team is seriously considering.
So are these features entirely taken care of by the software updates?
Sure.
Yeah.
If you address any glitch, if you add any new features, are they entirely taken care by software updates? There is no additional hardware thing required once you add any new feature?
So the development of device starting sometime 2015, up to now, all the updates that have happened on the software.
Okay.
There has been no tweaking of the hardware, because essentially that is not the plan. The point is to get all the updates, follow the kind of iOS Android kind of model, and get all the updates through software. As of now, nothing on the hardware has been done apart from after the final version of hardware was fixed. So all the updates are on software, and the things can be downloaded from the Android phone.
Sure.
Ajay, you said adding some new audio books, then there has to be a hardware change in terms of adding a speaker and a
yes, 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 yes.
So there will be a change. That will be required by any minutes.
I have three questions. One is, is it advisable for a person to use if he's not a Braille user at present, but is it possible for somebody to start learning on this device?
Okay, one question, learning. This device is absolutely good for people who
desktop no brain but to router. And let me tell you how. You connect the device to the computer, right? And you open a Word file. You type A on your computer, and the A will be displayed on the device. Right? You type B on the computer, and the B will be displayed on the device. So you can like sort of know, you can learn, because it's giving you simultaneously both inputs, both outputs. An audio output through NVDA and a brain output through the device. That is how you know what is corresponding to what, right? In fact, one of the functionality of this device being connected to phone and computer was that it will help people, like I said during the presentation, it will help people for teaching brain. And self-learning is also possible in that sense.
Question continuing to this is this device presently available in any kind of an organization at present so that people will have hands-on practice for the moment until they are, you know, not yet till they are able to use it?
So as of now, we are in talks with places such as Saksham, Enable India, and Sparsh. So we are in talks with distributors and organizations. The point right now, the stage we are in is the reach out stage that we are trying to let visually challenged people know that there is a device here. We are also, this device is also being used by a couple of visually challenged schools in and around Pune. One is with XRCVC, yes, XRCVC definitely we are in test. So we are in test with organizations, and some of these organizations do have the device right now. But we are on the reach out stage. So
okay, so I think we just need to, we have one small 10 minutes section left. So what we'll do is we'll continue our discussions after the session, if that's fine. Tony is right here, so you can also feel the device and see how it works. So after 10-15 minutes, we will continue this discussion.
So guys, thank you for the opportunity. And Lakshmi and I, both of us are carrying visiting cards of the development team. The office is located in IIT Powai campus. You are most welcome. We will give you the visiting cards with us. You can collect it. I will also drop the brochures that is not in Braille. We are sorry for that, but we will also drop the brochures and use the manuals with the organizers here at BGFI. You can collect it. We will email the user manual and other product related information to the BGFI email ID, so BGFI can circulate it.
Yes,
everyone have it. We welcome all of you to have a hands-on feel of the device. Either coming walking into our space with this IIT Powai, or we will let you know which organizations in and around Mumbai can facilitate this. Do give a ring or write to us using the contact you find on the PC card. Right. So thanks a lot on behalf of Innovation Tech. We will sign off Lakshmi and myself.
Thanks a lot, Innovation Tech, for that wonderful section, and more importantly for the wonderful design of that product. It's in India, that's where in India kuch bhi sasta karna hai, toh India bhi ho sakta hai. And we have Sagar also, Lakshmi Sagar, who is a quality checker. So aisa nahi hai ki sasta hai, toh quality nahi hai, quality must hai.
By the device is sold in US, so that's me, you can buy this.
Yeah, so do continue reading about it, it will circulate more details. So thanks a lot, Tony, and the entire Innovation Tech team. I will call upon Mr. Hasmukh Shah to hand over the moment to Tony Kurien.
Okay, for the sake of recording, then I'll use the mic. Please give me a round of applause in advance so I know how many people are there in the room. Big round of applause. Okay, thank you. अच्छा किसी ने भी चार हाथों से नहीं बजाए तो ज्यादा लोग नहीं है बट बेसिकली आई थिंक BGFI हैव बीन ऑर्गेनाइजिंग दिस वेरी यूजफुल सेशंस एंड आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल दैट दे हैव गिवन मी अ प्लेटफॉर्म टू टू नो फॉर फर्दर व्हाट आई लाइक दैट इज स्पोर्ट्स I'm not sure if how many of you are also focusing on sports, what's happening around the world and in India especially. Once upon a time, Mumbai and Maharashtra were in the forefront. So the second oldest organization called National Sports Club for Blind was formed in Mumbai in 1991, which was the second oldest. And then, I don't know, probably lack of interest or leadership, things died down, but I've always been a sporty person. During my board exams also, I would go and play cricket and all that. But nowadays, I'm really lonely and I don't feel that I have any friends to play with. So I came and I thought, kahin pe yahan pe logo ko zara jagah do. If they know and they like it, they can come and join me. This is the ball that is in my hand. So when I was in the UK, ladies and gentlemen, they play every game possible there. Yeah. So
I'll pass it from the right. No, I'm passing the mic. So you can see.
Yeah. So in UK, visually impaired play archery. They do horse riding. They do. They play tennis. This is the tennis ball, long tennis ball. They play goalball and they play all sorts of Paralympic games. Now, just a bit of about this game. I'm going to pass on this tennis racket also, which is a junior 25 racket, and Tony has a 23 one. My racket is broken now, so never mind. This is to get you introduced to a game which perhaps is not as muddy as cricket or other games which you are used to playing, and some people may like it better than other games, you know. That's why I'm here to introduce it. what happens in this game, as you can hear, and if you know a little about long tennis, which sighted people play, they play it on one bounce. I don't mind, there is nobody naughty here who is bouncing the ball yet, so it's really, you guys have to get really sporty about it. हम लोग IIT बॉम्बे में थैंक्स टू टोनी हर संडे 4-7 सेशंस करते हैं सेशंस इज अ वेरी बोरिंग टर्म फॉर मी ऑनेस्टली सो हम लोग प्रैक्टिस करते हैं खेलते हैं वार्म अप बहुत कम करते हैं सो इफ यू गाइस आर इंटरेस्टेड एनीबडी ऑफ यू फॉर फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट इट इज दैट वी आर वेलकमिंग यू जस्ट टू स्प्रेड लास्ट USP ऑफ दिस गेम इज एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वन इज इट इज very women friendly also. I mean, ladies really enjoy this. I'm seeing it in the UK and I'm seeing it here that they're really liking it because first of all, you just need one buddy to play with. You don't need other 10 to play cricket kind of a game. You don't need a very big ground. You don't need many umpiring or other support staff. You just need a simple concrete 40x20 kind of a place and you can play with this kind of a game. If you have any questions, you can ask me now because I'm not going to make it boring. If you are interested, you'll automatically come and play with us. I really invite all of you to at least have a look at it and let us know if you will be interested to play this game. Thank you.
Thanks.
Sir, how are you?
There's no enrollment, there's no registration, there's no all those big bureaucratic things. There's a group on NCCI, BGFI has been very gracious to let me put this messages.
So, to be honest, I'm first rule breaker, so I'm not a very good organizer. So I am in co-eds with National Sports Club for the Blind, and we are trying to revive it. We are trying to get funds for it. We are trying to make a good website. We are trying to get content. So no enrollment to answer your question. Just focus on the messages which are coming on BGFI Connect.
Yes.
Yeah, Connect team. And just ping me, or once you come in for practice, then you become part of another WhatsApp group called Sound for Long Tense, and then you'll be always updated about the happenings. Just to give you an idea of things to come, we'll be soon getting formal recognition from International Blind Tennis Association, and about more than 20 countries are already playing this game. There have been international tennis tournament last year. It's happening in Ireland in a month's time. So it's a huge game all over. This was started by, I must give a tribute to this guy who was like having a skida or sports, and he couldn't play with his brothers long tennis, normal long tennis. And he struggled for 12 odd years to get this ball done. His Miyoshi Taki, who is no more there, is a Japanese guy. So Japan still manufactures this. The ball which you're seeing right now is not manufactured anywhere else but in Japan right now. So you can import it from UK, Australia and all that, but Japan is the only manufacturer. And how to enroll is just ping us. Tomorrow we have a practice from 4 to 7. Rest we can take offline.
By seeing the color of the ball, I think it is basically designed for totally blind. But since I am a low vision, is the ball available in different colors, or is it mandatory to play blindfolded?
Good question. So we currently internationally and in the country, we're going to have three bands. They might increase their B1, B2, B3. So people who are just using some, I don't know, a very technical definition. But जो अच्छा खासा देख पा रहे हैं उनके लिए B3 की कैटेगरी होती है, and they get two bounces, they have to play with the same ball, and they don't have to wear any blindfold. But if you're playing for B1 category, जो almost पूरी पत्ती फुल होती है, तो they have to wear blindfold. I don't need any of that, just can't do it. This is a black ball, if I'm not wrong. So you have two variants, black and yellow one. I am going to place an order for the yellow ones because I have been partially sad and know that it makes a big difference. So we'll have it ported yellow ones also.
No women, no questions from any women?
No women, Baba. Yeah, my number is 7303. 178-758.
Sundays 4 to 7.
Sundays as of now 4 to 7, and other ports we are trying to open up, so we remove these restrictions and barriers where blind person or visually impaired has to travel from Virar to Churchgate just to play a match. So we are developing people who can just go to a next door tennis court and start playing. That's my personal ambition. So it's working very well in New Mumbai. We have got multiple courts. So anybody staying in New Mumbai, we can even play today night kind of a thing. So do contribute. As I say, if you don't enjoy sports, you can come in as a administrator, leadership. There's a lot of opportunities. We're going to approach corporates for sponsors and CSR funds. So any help, any guidance will be welcome.